Hello guys, and welcome to this another episode of the Warband Let's Play series. This time I have for you a 5 rounds, and this is what I'm going to be doing basically when I'm playing native Warband, is just playing 5 rounds at a certain class, at a certain map, at a certain server, and just stick with that class for the entirety of the round. Today I'm playing on Central Palm. You can see I'm Sarranid, and I'm rocking the Sarranid Cavalry class. With 1500 gold, with 52 denarii remaining, you can pretty much get the Sarranid horse, you can get your heavy lance, default sword and default shield, and you can also get the armor that I have on. I'm not sure what it's called. I think it's just called Sarranid armor, and I think that's called the Nomad cap or something like that. But yeah. So basically we're playing against the Nords, and I'm having a little bit of trouble against this guy over here because, you know, he's judging range well and using his, I forget what that weapon is called well, because it's very rarely seen. There's an archer in the vicinity, so I'm just gonna run away like a little bitch. That's what I do. But, you'll see pretty much a lot in this round that I get a pretty decent score, and it's mainly because I just get around their archers and hit people from the back and cause a bunch of chaos in their back lines and stuff. But yeah, pretty much. Not much really goes on, but I will comment when I, you know, when I do a certain thing, or I will draw your attention to certain aspects, definitely. So this is exactly what I'm talking about, getting behind their archers. But this guy hears me at the last minute, but that's not gonna stop me from dealing some damage for this round. And I kill that guy, but he kills my horse somehow, and I'm gonna get up and try to fight those guys on foot. And the hold works on that guy perfectly, so that's good. I really dislike axes with archers, but KOA Magnificent, against his name suggests, actually helped me out. So, this is one thing I don't like about fastest combat speed, is how fast the archers can shoot. Like, look at that. I think that's ridiculous. Like, archers can shoot really quick. They can break your shield while you're running up a hill, but that's not gonna stop me from butchering his ass. So, thanks for breaking my shield, buddy. I think that's Sheepskin over here, and he's gonna make quick work of me, but that doesn't matter. Good round, good first round, got 5 kills. Didn't upgrade anything because I died, even though you can see I still have some extra bit of gold. And here I'm trying to find my teammate, Laurie, who is beastly on Cav. Like, this guy doesn't get off his horse unless you force him off his horse, or like shoot his horse off. He'll play Village and go Cav, that's how crazy he is. Nord Cav is really quite underpowered, unless you can hit people in the head with javelins all the time. Some people can do that, but it's generally like in scrims and stuff like this. Nord Cav are seen as the weakest Cav, mainly because they don't get the lance advantage. So now I'm going to go around their archers, because there's a nice little hill here, and if I can come from the back, they wouldn't see me at all. Because the server is quite full at this time, you can do things like this really easily, and it gets you some easy kills, which gets you good money, and then you can, you know, you figure it out from there. You get easy kills, easy money. It's just gonna be more easy kills and more money. So look how many unaware archers I'm about to hit right here. So many of them. And that spearman is pretty smart. He's watching the backs. But these guys aren't. They're too focused on our archers. I'm just gonna run around and hit them from the back while they're not looking. Again, easy free kills. This is what Cav should do, really. Cav, I wouldn't say it's underpowered, but if you get stabbed by a spear, from a guy who's riding a horse at full gallop. You need to die, regardless of what kind of armor you wear. And most of the time, we end up seeing, you know, people surviving stuff like that. So I'm just cleaning up here. Like, look at these guys. They're getting mowed. And that guy stopped my horse, and he is gonna cause my death eventually, I think. Yeah. That guy got around me pretty well, and a lol for the lols. We ended up, I think, losing that round. Yep. Or no, we ended up winning that round. Yep. And I'm running 10-2 on the second round, so it kind of shows you what kind of easy kills you can really get with this setup. Especially on large servers. I mean, I wouldn't be doing this and getting high score if it wasn't for people. If you know, you actually had some skilled people who are playing together and communicating. But this is a pub. You come on here for this kind of stuff. It's really individual practice and how you can deal with different situations. So I don't really have much to add or to say. I'm just gonna leave you guys to watch the last three rounds of this five-round warband. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember to comment, rate, and subscribe. And just a little quick thing. Some of you may be aware that the Vikinger mod has been released, and I've been playing that quite a lot, and it is one of the most beautiful mods that has been released from Warband yet, in my opinion. It's a small mod for multiplayer, but they've added some really nice features, and they've done things quite well. I'm just gonna steal an AFK kill. free money. But yeah, I'm going to be doing a series on that. I'm going to be taking you guys through every single map, and it's gonna be kind of like a preview on what Vikinger has to offer. It's really cool, so if you want to kind of like get a jump start, you might want to check it out. So yeah, I'll see you guys next video.